This call is now being recorded.
Okay, let's start. Today's lecture is based on topic Ethernet, also known as wired LAN. It is the 13th lecture. So in this slide, we will cover IEEE standards. In 1985, the Computer Society of the IEEE started a project called Project 802 to set standard to enable intercommunication among equipment from a variety of manufacturers. Project 802 is a way of specifying the functions of the physical layer and the data link layer of major LAN protocol. Okay. Although we have already covered physical and data link layer, so that's why after that we are covering the Ethernet part. Okay. If you will follow OSI model, you will see that physical layer on top of that data link layer, and on top of data link layer, other layers will be there. Similarly, IEEE standard says that data link layer will be divided into two parts. One is logical link control, and there is MAC. MAC is medium access control. Okay, that MAC can be three type or maybe more than that: Ethernet MAC, token ring MAC, token bus MAC. Okay, and that similar way, physical layer that can be Ethernet physical layer, token ring physical layer, and token bus physical layer. So you just need to learn that IEEE standard for LANs divide the data link layer into LLC and MAC. MAC can be type 1, type 2, type 3 or other types. Similar way, physical layer can be Ethernet type, token ring type, token bus type or other. So what we will cover in this slide? We will cover this Ethernet token ring, token bus type of MAC, okay, and physical layer. So HDLC frame compared with LLC and MAC frame. Okay, so generally HDLC frame format already given to you in another class, where this is that there will be address, there will be control, data and FCS. So in MAC frame, they use as MAC header and data part, that is MAC payload, and same as FCS. That MAC payload is again divided into DSAP, that is destination service access point, SSAP, source service access point, then control information, then upper layer data. So this slide shows that how HDLC frame format is different from MAC frame format. Okay. So we will start with the standard Ethernet. Okay. Standard Ethernet is the type 1. Original Ethernet was created in 1976 at PARC. That is your Palo Alto Research Center. Since then, it has gone through four generations. Those four generations will be covered in this slide. First generation is standard Ethernet, then fast Ethernet, then gigabit Ethernet, 10 gigabit Ethernet. Okay. So first generation says that standard speed will be 10 Mbps, then 100 Mbps, then 1 Gbps, then 10 Gbps. Okay, so these are the Ethernet evolution through 4 generations. Okay, whatever developed in this period, it is of standard Ethernet of speed 10 Mbps, fast Ethernet of 100 Mbps, gigabit Ethernet of 1 Gbps, then 10 gigabit Ethernet of 10 Gbps. Okay, that is the type of evolution of Ethernet. Clear? In all cases, in this type of Ethernet, this Ethernet is numbered as 802.3. Okay. This all type of Ethernet are numbered as 802.3. So in 802.3 MAC frame format, they use as first preamble of 7 byte. Okay. Then start frame delimiter, that is flag, of 1 byte. Destination address of 6 byte. Source address of 6 byte, length of data or type of data, then data and padding, that is data part, then your CRC information of 4 byte. Okay. So this preamble part may have 56 bits of alternating ones and zeros. Okay. So this is the MAC frame format for 802.3. So, if you see carefully, that data and padding length is not mentioned here. What should be that length? That length maximum can be 1500 bytes, minimum can be 46 bytes. Okay. So, after taking care of minimum and maximum data length, so you have the frame length. Minimum can be 512 bits and maximum can be 12144 bits. Okay, so this range depend upon data and padding part. Okay, so this is important for your class test kind of quiz, that what is the maximum, what is the minimum, okay, frame length possible. Now MAC, okay, so MAC means medium access control. It uses a address known as MAC address. Generally MAC address, as I have said, it will be of 6 byte. 6 byte means it is like your 48 bits or 12 hexadecimal digits. Okay, like this 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. So that is 12 hexadecimal digits. Okay. Or if we convert it into bits, it will be 48 bits. Okay. Or you can set it as 6 byte. Okay. That is the example of an Ethernet address, or known as MAC address. Okay. Ethernet address and MAC address, okay, example is given here in hexadecimal format. So in this address, this part, okay, means first part, byte 1, okay, then byte 2, byte 3, byte 4, byte 5, byte 6. So this byte 1, okay, how many length it can be? The byte is of 8 bit, okay, 8 bits into 6, that is 48. That's why the maximum length is 48. Okay, each part is of 8 bit, okay, 8 bit, 16 bit, 32 bit, 64 bit. Okay, so each will be of 8 bit. Okay, so total 6 portion, so it is of 8 plus 8 plus 8 plus 8, it will be of maximum will be 48 bits. Okay, in 48 bits, only take the first 8 bit, that is your byte 1. In the byte 1, see this position. Okay, Okay. In the first byte, check this position of the address, whether it is 0 or 1. Basically, if it is 0, that will mean that it is unicast address. And if it is 1, that will mean that it is multicast address. Okay. That is the way to identify unicast and multicast address. So the theory says the least significant bit of the first byte defines the type of address. If the bit is 0, it is unicast. Otherwise, it is multicast. Okay. If you have not understood, let's see an example. Okay. Let's take, this is a MAC address. To identify it is unicast type or multicast type, how to do that? You will check for what? To find the type of address, we need to look at the second hexadecimal digit from the left. If it is even, the address is unicast. If it is odd, the address is multicast. If all digits are F, the address is broadcast. Okay. Therefore, we have the following. So this address is unicast because A in binary is 1010. Okay. So check this 4A. In 4A, you have to see A. Okay. Check A. If you convert A into binary, it is 1010. So what is the last bit? 0. Since it is 0, it is unicast. Okay. Similarly, for this MAC address, check for 7. Convert this 7 into binary. What will we get? We will get this 0111. Since this is 1, means it is multicast. Okay. So that's why 7 in binary shows you 111, so it is multicast. Okay. One more thing, the broadcast destination address is a special case of multicast address in which all bits are 1. Okay. Whenever you will see that kind of address, all are FFF, means what? If we convert it into binary, all will be 1111111. Okay, that will be your broadcast. So three type of address: unicast address, broadcast address, multicast address. Okay, unicast for 0, multicast for 1, broadcast for all values are FF, or converted into binary, if all are 1, then it is broadcast. Okay. So let's revise it again. What we have covered? We have covered Ethernet evolutions. So type 1, type 2, type 3, type 4. All users make MAC frame format. This is the format. Then in the destination address, they use a 6-byte information. For destination source, the 6-byte is what? It is MAC address. Okay. MAC address. So this MAC address example is this. So in this example, in the MAC type, check for this position. Okay. Convert this into binary. If binary value for some reason it is 0, it is unicast. If for some reason it is 1, then it is multicast. If all the informations are 1, then it is broadcast. Okay, this is a summary. Let me know who have understood MAC protocol address. Let me know in the comment. So if you have understood MAC address, let's continue with the type 1. Okay, type 1 Ethernet, that is standard Ethernet. Okay, type 1 means in the first slide, just I have shown that that is type 1 standard Ethernet of 10 Mbps speed. Okay, so 10 Mbps speed standard Ethernet can be categorized into four types that are 10 base 5, 10 base 2, 10 base T, 10 base F. Observe that all of them are written as 10. Okay, this 10 represent speed. Okay, 10 base 5 is also known as bus thick coaxial. It is bus thin coaxial. It is known as star UTP. It is known as star fiber. Okay, so basically what it does, it uses 10 Mbps data. Okay, that will be fed, that will be given through some kind of base. We have studied na Manchester encoding, Manchester you have remembered. So it will be given through Manchester encoder. Okay, pop speed 10 Mbps data will be sent through Manchester encoder through a station, then through twisted pair or fiber optical it will be transmitted at the receiver, where it will decode depend upon Manchester encoding, and it will return 10 Mbps data. Okay, so 10 base 5 mean 10 is your speed, 5 is your length of the cable. Whenever it is written as 5, it is known as length. 5 means 500 meter. Okay, 500 meter maximum cable support means from station 1 to station 2, maximum cable length can be 500 meter. Okay, where in 10 base 5, the base mean baseband. What kind of modulation it will be used? Baseband modulation, that is digital modulation will be used. Okay, similarly 10 base 2 means 10 is the speed, baseband modulation, and 2 is your length. Here maximum length possible is 185. So 185 they are representing in nearest form as 200. Okay, although 200 is not supported, just for representation they are during as 200, so they are taking it as 2. Okay, 10 base 2. In 10 base 2, thin coaxial cable will be used whose maximum length will be 185. They will be connected from cable end to the other cable end. Okay, 10 base 2. So this is 10 base 5, it is 10 base 2. So what is 10 base T? In 10 base T, T part is representing twisted pair, okay, and rest 10 Mbps speed baseband transmission, and it is twisted pair. It means they uses two pair of unshielded twisted pair cable. Okay, that is 10 base T implementation. And in 10 base F, they uses F for fiber optic cable. Okay, for communication they uses two fiber optic cables. That's why it is known as 10 base F. So if you closely compare them, you will see that 10 base 5 uses thick coaxial cable of 500 meter maximum length and uses Manchester encoding. Similar way, 10 base 2, 10 base T, 10 base F, they uses 10 base 2 uses 185 meter, 10 base T uses 100 meter, 10 base F uses 200 meter. Means for long distance communication, you can use fiber optic from point 1 to point 2. If it is beyond your 500 meter, you can use fiber optic. Okay, so for comparison, you use 3 parameter: media, maximum length, encoding, and you write the values. Okay, what type of media used, what is the maximum length, what type of line of encoding they use. So slowly they are able to improve the speed of the network with the help of some kind of network where they use as now it has 100 speed. Okay, next category is fast Ethernet implementation, where they are able to improve the speed from 10 to 100 Mbps with the help of different type of topologies like star topology. This fast Ethernet are divided into three types. Okay, in 100 base TX they use as two wire category 5 UTP. Okay, that is two wires fiber, and next four wires category 3 unshielded twisted pair. Okay, first is 100 base TX, 100 base FX, 100 base T4. If you closely compare them, you will be able to see that 10 base TX uses CAT 5 unshielded twisted pair or shielded twisted pair. Okay, so number of wire used by 100 base TX is 2, maximum length supported is 100 meter, lock encoding used is 4P or 5P. Okay, and line encoding uses MLT. These two terms are not explained to you. These details you can find in Google. So for comparison, you can write these terms, but explanations are not required here. 10 base FX uses fiber optic cable. Two wires will be used. Maximum will be 100 meter. Okay, and lock encoding will be 4P or 5P type. Line encoding will be not written to zero inversion. It is covered in your syllabus. Next category, 100 base T4 uses CAT4 UTP and it's a twisted pair. Number of wires will be 4. Maximum length support is 100 meter. Lock encoding is not used here. Line encoding used is 8B60. Okay. So for fast Ethernet, at least you should write for media, number of wires and maximum length. Okay. In gigabit Ethernet, they even now improved the speed to 1000 Mbps. Okay, that is gigabit Ethernet uses 1000 Mbps. Still they uses baseband modulation with some specification as SX, LX, CX and T. Okay, where SX termed as short wave fiber. They use a short wave fiber. And second category uses long wave fiber, third category uses copper wire, and fourth category uses unshielded twisted pair wires. Okay, so let's compare them with cable. So depend upon media, number of wires, maximum length and block encoding, line encoding, they are categorized as type 1, type 2, type 3, type 4. So here you can observe the media used for type 1, media used for type 2, media used for type 3, okay, then for type 4. Similarly, number of wire, maximum length supported, okay, type of block encoding, type of line encoding. So basically, what is covered here actually? See, in this slide, only there are details, technical details given. If you are using network, what type of network you are using? Okay, that can be speed of 10 Mbps, known as standard Ethernet, or fast Ethernet, gigabit Ethernet, and 10 gigabit Ethernet. In all these cases, there will be different types. Similarly, standard Ethernet covered, fast Ethernet covered, gigabit Ethernet covered, and the last one is your 10 gigabit Ethernet, where they use 10G base S, 10G base L, and 10G base E. So medium uses short wave of 815 nm multi mode, long wave of 1310 nm that is single mode, and this uses fiber optic of length 1550 nm single mode use. The single mode is what? It is for fiber optic cable. Okay, if this is a cable, only one radiation on light is sent. Okay, that is single mode. Maximum length supported is 300 meter, then 10 kilometer, then 40 kilometer. Okay, so there can be quiz question like what type of Ethernet can be used. Write the specification of Ethernet for maximum length of 40 kilometer. Then you should be able to write 10G base E. Okay, my handwriting is too poor. 10G base E. Similar way, there can be questions like in case of 1000 base T, what type of media is used? So you should be able to write category 5 UTP. Okay, so in this slide only you need to learn the specification of Ethernet of various type. Okay, various types of Ethernet, their specifications, and what is MAC address, and how to identify unicast, multicast, and broadcast address. Only this part are covered in this syllabus, in this slide. Okay, so any questions?